Increase your Wi-Fi range while camping. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is the situation I found myself in last week. I was in my trailer camping at a family member's. We like to basically take our own bedroom, bathroom, and kitchen along with us. But where we were, we had two problems. One is that one of the solutions I typically use for connectivity when I'm in the trailer is a little Wi-Fi MiFi. It's basically something that is provided by my mobile company that is essentially a portable mobile hotspot. It connects up to the mobile network and provides me with a Wi-Fi connection. Unfortunately, the mobile connection in general for it or for my phone or whatever was really, really marginal to the extent that it would drop fairly often. Now, there was also Wi-Fi on premises, but unfortunately, the Wi-Fi signal, the way I had things positioned, was particularly weak. Again, we could get on it occasionally, but unfortunately, it wasn't really strong enough to maintain a connection and do some of the things that I needed to or wanted to do. So I decided that it was time for an experiment because while I was visiting a family member last week, this is a situation that I've run into before while camping. Wi-Fi is provided by wherever you happen to be, but you really don't have any control over how good it is, how strong it is, and where it is with respect to where you end up parking. So the experiment that I ran was to try a Wi-Fi range extender. I got one. I ended up purchasing a TP-Link AC750 Wi-Fi extender. It's small, it's convenient. It is something that I could just plug into one of the outlets in my trailer and, assuming it would work, let it do its magic. Now, the important thing about a Wi-Fi range extender, the thing you need to realize is that it is another hop. It's another link in the chain. What that means is that your speed might be impacted somewhat by using an extender. The issue is that rather than your data going from your computer, my laptop in my case, to the eventual hotspot, it has to take a detour. It goes to the range extender and then from the range extender onto the hotspot. And yeah, that takes time because what happens is the range extender receives all of the data before it can turn around and pass it on to the hotspot. The idea behind a range extender is that if you've got a distance between your laptop or your device wanting to use Wi-Fi and the access point that has a weak signal, the range extender can live somewhere in the middle where it's close enough to the access point to be able to receive and send a strong signal there, and close enough to your device, my laptop in my case, to be able to provide and send a strong signal there as well. Now, it's a little bit iffy in my case. The reason I keep calling it an experiment is because in reality, it's going to be super close to my laptop, right? Trailers aren't big. So we've got it at one end of the trailer. I've got it plugged in and the laptop is doing its thing. And sure enough, it's got a nice strong signal as I would expect. The real experiment part of this was that I wasn't sure if the issues that were causing my Wi-Fi signal to be weak for my laptop would also cause it to be equivalently weak for this range extender. What I was betting on is that the range extender is designed for exactly this situation. It has bigger, more obvious antenna associated with it. Unlike the laptop, of course, where everything is kind of sort of hidden inside the box. By its nature, that means that the antenna can't necessarily be as big and as obvious and as powerful as the ones you might have for a dedicated purpose device. And sure enough, I plugged it in, I configured it. There's definitely some configuration involved, but it really, really did the trick. Not only was it getting and sending a strong signal to the Wi-Fi access point on premises, but like I said, I'm really close to it inside of my trailer, so I get a really, really strong signal there as well. And my transmission speeds went from basically pokey, to use a technical term, to and pokey and dropping occasionally, which is, of course, the most frustrating part of it. There's a certain amount of speed degradation we're willing to tolerate in situations like that. But when it gets so bad that connections are dropping, that becomes a non-starter. Anyway, it went from pokey to full speed. As far as I could tell, the Wi-Fi range extender and my Wi-Fi in general was no longer the limiting factor. The limiting factor was the upstream ISP connection. So all in all, it was a very, very successful experiment and something that I would recommend for you to try in situations where you might end up with Wi-Fi signals that you want to use that are out of your control to bring them closer in a way that perhaps would allow you to connect more securely, more strongly, more whatever, wherever you happen to be. Now, one of the pieces of pushback that I expect to get, Leo, you're using Wi-Fi and you're camping? Just disconnect already. That's what camping is all about. Well, it may be true for you. Absolutely, I get that. And there are times, absolutely, when I need and want to disconnect. This wasn't one of them. And in fact, like I said, this was a family visit, not a vacation. So it was important that I be able to remain connected and run Ask Leo, do the things that I do outside of Ask Leo and so forth, basically remain online for the duration of that visit. Nonetheless, when we do go camping, there are campsites we go to that have Wi-Fi provided, and absolutely, I never really disconnect completely in most situations. I'm at least checking email because I need to remain in contact with the people that are taking care of my house or our friends or whomever, and making sure that, you know, there aren't like emergencies happening with respect to the business. So regardless of whether or not you should or should not disconnect while camping, it's important to be able to understand that when you need to stay connected, there are ways to make it better, stronger, and more reliable. Anyway, if you ever find yourself in a situation like this, I hope this helps. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/145176. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.